Hey guys, welcome back. So I've been playing around with these buck converters for quite a while now, and I'm trying to find the perfect one. And so I've been testing many different manufacturers, and some will have a good input voltage, but will have like a 12 volt output. Or maybe the output will be 13.8 volts, but it won't do well with batteries, but it will do well with appliances. So after trying a lot of these and not having any really good success finding one unit that will basically rule them all, I called up XWST and I had them make it. They actually produced one for me. I told them the specs I wanted, which was 18 to 90 volts input and 13.8 volts, 20 amps output. And this is it. This is the unit. This one does not exist. This is like the only one right now in the world. So it's pretty cool. This converter is direct order from China. I have a link on my website where you can order it. It's $45. I get zero commission. I just wanted to pass this information on to you guys so that you have the best choice out there, and that is this unit. So yeah, probably not worth shipping back because the shipping will cost as much as the unit. So yeah, I think it's definitely worth $45. This unit will do everything. It'll power USB devices, it'll power 12 volt appliances, it'll charge batteries quite well as well. We're also gonna take a look at this USB converter. So basically you can take input voltage of 8 volts to 85 volts. So that's pretty awesome actually. So you can use like smaller 12 volt solar panels with this, and you can power USB devices directly if that's all you need. And this puts out 3 amps, which will power any USB device. And you won't have to deal with wiring up a panel or wiring up. All you gotta do is connect some MC4 connectors to this, and you're ready to go. Let's get started. Okay, so currently we have the converter plugged into the large panel, the 335 watt panel on the right. I have my saucepan. I did not use this one in the last video, so we're gonna use the saucepan this time, and we're gonna see how long it takes to boil some water and boil a couple of eggs because I haven't eaten yet. And we're gonna see how hot these wires get since we upgraded them. It's just after 10 a.m. so we're not getting full power from that panel. Should get at least, I don't know, a couple hundred watts right now. So it's 13.8, we'll plug it in. This thing uses, I think, 13 amps. So actually there, yeah, we're getting full power. It dropped only to 13.3, so that's holding voltage very well. We put in our eggs. If you get one of these converters and you notice a huge voltage drop, that means your solar panel is likely not putting out enough power. So whatever the amps is on your device, so this is 13, you times that by 13.8 volts, which is the output of this converter. That gives you, how many watts it's going to require to power this thing. Sitting at about 98 degrees right now. Temperature sensor has two lasers, and I found out you have to have both dots on the object you're trying to measure. So since this connection is so tiny, it's pretty impossible for me to line up both dots on that. So I don't know how accurate of a reading we're going to get. The connector's warm, but the wire is perfectly fine. So we're sitting at 13.3 amps right now. Alright, we'll come back in about 20 minutes. Yeah, this one that's not wrapped, not heat-shrinked, yeah, you can't touch that for more than a couple seconds. But the ones that are heat-shrinked, you can hold on to them fine. No more than 15 amps on these things, which is all you really need to power any of the USB devices I showed you in the video. About 170 degrees. Okay, it's been about 45 minutes now, and the water is boiling nicely. So we'll give it about 10 more minutes, and we'll check the eggs. Temperature on our wires are the same. 200 degrees on the saucepan. Wow. See how hot that is? That's pretty hot. Ooh, still pretty hot. Alright, so these should be well boiled. Oh yeah. Perfect. Yeah, so when using these 12 volt appliances, it takes about an hour, even in perfect conditions, perfect 100% power. It can take about an hour to get an egg fully cooked, and that goes for pretty much all the 12 volt appliances. So you gotta be a little bit patient. More efficient than say a 1500 watt kettle or whatever, but definitely takes longer. So now I've added a battery into the mix, and we're gonna basically have a complete 12 volt solar system at this point. And I added a small USB light. It's an easy way to see if we have power. So the light is on, right? If I disconnect our solar, we have no power because we're not connected to the battery yet. Now our light's on, but no solar. You can see right there, 12.2 volts. So now we'll connect our solar. So check it out. So using the 300 watt solar panel, we're actually pushing 11 amps into this battery. So that's pretty good. Our battery voltage is nearing 13 volts. That's with the 330 watt panel. Let's connect a 100 watt panel and see the difference in the amps output. Connected to the small 100 watt panel there. The solar is disconnected, but you can see our light is running from our battery at this point. And this is what I want to stress. I can't stress this enough, guys. This is the most basic, complete solar system you could have. Now, this is a 12 volt system only. You can't run AC appliances. You can only run DC appliances, but you can even get a small, one of my viewers got a small, like 200 watt car adapter plug-in AC inverter, and they were able to run that off of the car adapter outlet. So you could do AC, but you have to keep it like under 200 watts. So we'll connect up our solar. Now that our solar's connected, look, I can disconnect the battery, right? And the light still stays on, because now we have two power sources. Once you introduce a battery into the system, you have a complete solar system. And even though the solar panel is only 100 watts, the fact that we're charging the battery in the day, you could power a 12 volt appliance like this. Normally, if I try to power that 12 volt appliance off this, off of that 100 watt panel, it wouldn't work. But because we have a battery that can sit there and charge all day off a 100 watt panel, even a 50 watt panel, you can still utilize that power and get all the amps from your battery at nighttime. So that's the value of a battery in a solar system. Just to demonstrate that, we'll try to power our 12 volt appliance here with just the solar. So I'm going to disconnect the battery. You can see, look at the voltage drop all the way down to 8 volts. So that's really not enough. Let's see how many amps that is. It takes 13 amps to power this thing fully. And look at that, we're only getting 8.3 amps. But when you introduce a battery to the mix, right? Now we'll connect our battery. These have plenty of amps. In fact, this car battery has 500 cranking amps, so. Now look at that, our amps go right up, and now we can supply our device, 12 amps. So that's the value of a battery in a solar system, and that is a complete 12 volt system, and it's cheap. I mean, you're talking 50 bucks for a converter, 20 bucks for this USB panel outlet, and just a junky car battery you might find anywhere, really. So the 100 watt panel is producing only 5.4 amps. Versus the, 11 amps, over 11 amps we're getting from the 335 watt panel. So if you want to regulate the power to your battery, then you need to use a smaller solar panel. Now the cool thing about this, how I can just disconnect the battery at will, right? And our light still stays powered. You can't do that with the charge controller. In fact, if you read the manual in the charge controller, oftentimes it will say, do not connect the solar without a battery. So you have to have a battery connected first and then connect your solar. So I have a junky charge controller. We're actually going to try that and see what happens if you don't obey the rules. So that'll be interesting. But let's test a LiPo 4 battery. Okay, so just to show you the versatility of this system, now I got the cables connected to the 250 watt panel on the left. leaning against the wall. So I've used all three panels now. Okay, so I don't know if you guys remember, but in my previous video, with this battery, we were only able to get 1% state of charge because LiPo4s reach 13 volts very quickly. So you need more voltage than that to be able to get it charged up. So a little note about these converters. This is a 276 watt output. So whatever the output on this is, say it's 200 watts or 250 or whatever, you don't need to exceed that with the solar panels. You don't connect these to like a huge array of solar panels. There's no point. You'll never utilize the power from that panel. This puts out what it puts out and that's it. So if this one puts out 276, so a 300 watt panel, it's perfect for this unit. Whatever you need to power, if you're powering just USB devices, you can use a 20 watt panel. So these are very flexible in what they will handle, this particular unit anyway. And check it out. This battery is currently at 58% state of charge, right? And we're still pushing 9.6 amps. Now, when I was testing this, I actually got it, by the time it finally leveled out and finally stopped pushing any amps, the battery was at 98%. So that's really awesome. So basically you can fully charge a battery, 12 volt battery. And that goes for any 12 volt battery. Car battery, lead acid, sealed lead acid, AGM, LiPo 4. And now we got our old junky charge controller connected to our battery. We have our USB panel wired to the load port as well. Load port acts just like the buck converter. It's the same function, but it's a little smarter because you can control it through the charge controller. So, first page on this manual, you'll find in pretty much all the charge controller manuals. Warning, do not connect solar before the battery. Always connect battery first. So, I have the breaker connected to the largest solar panel because we want to try to blow this thing up and we're going to see what happens. Well, first we'll do the normal thing, we'll connect the battery. The display comes on, and since I've told the load port to be always on, this our load comes on. Our light lights up. Now it's going to start charging the battery. This is the normal way, right? And now it's charging. We're charging with 18 amps. We'll disconnect the battery, so now it's off. Now we're gonna connect the solar. This is what you shouldn't do, right? And so the main difference, a lot of people will say, why not use a charge controller? Well, the difference is, right, you need a battery to operate this thing. So question is, can we use the load port directly off the solar without the battery? So our battery is disconnected, and now we're gonna turn on the solar. And this is what you should not do. It came on. So we got an error. Look at no battery, right? There's an error and the load port is not working. So it won't even attempt to do the load port. Now it didn't blow up, but we do get an error, so I guess that's the extent of it. However, what if you had this configured for 24 volt? And then plug the solar in, what would happen? Let's find out. This thing's a pain in the butt to use. Let's go 24. So I think it's on 24 and now it's blinking. So we'll turn off the battery and we'll turn on the solar. Same thing, we just get an error that the battery's not connected. But the load port definitely does not operate. You can see it will not push any power to the load port. So there you have it, there's the difference. Yeah, will it blow up? Probably not. But you gotta think, an emergency situation and your system shuts down, whatever your solar disconnects, or sorry, your battery disconnects, whatever reason, it would be silly for these things just to blow up, right? So at least there's some protection in there. Okay, so now we're going to test the efficiency of the buck converter versus our charge controller. And we have the buck converter currently connected to the 335 watt panel. And it's high noon, so We have our light. This light takes like no power, so it won't affect the test. And we're just going to measure the amps, see how many amps we can get out of each device. It's light overcast, so I'm trying to get the best results waiting for the clouds to break, but let's go ahead and connect up the buck converter to the battery. 12 amps. I've seen it as high as 15 amps today with no clouds. So right now we're getting 12. 13.2. So let's quickly connect up the charge controller and see if we can beat 13 amps. Okay, so now we got the solar panel connected to the charge controller. Let's see how many amps we can get. It's currently overcast and we're already beating 13 amps. So you can already see how much more efficient a charge controller is over a buck converter. 16 on the clamp meter. So I'm pretty surprised actually how effective the buck converter was. It probably wouldn't do well in clouds. It has no MPPT, so it can't track the changes in the solar panel voltage output. So overall, if you were to use that on a continual basis, you just wouldn't produce as much. So based on that 15 amp number I saw on the converter, we're at least 5 amps better with the charge controller. 22. Okay, so the last thing I want to show you on this video is the USB Anywhere converter. So I call it USB Anywhere because you can literally connect this thing to any DC power source and get USB power. So if you had like a Arduino device or something you want to supply and you have a 48 volt battery bank, just connect one of these little guys and you got USB power. So right now we're just going to connect it to a 12 volt battery. And since the input range is 8 to 85, you can connect it to a 12 volt battery just fine. So there we have it. We're powering our USB light right off the converter. Or if you don't have a battery and you have solar only, no problem. Connect your solar MC4 connectors. Solar power. USB anywhere. This thing is awesome. Yeah, so I was quite surprised how well the buck converter did against the charge controller. If it put out a slightly higher voltage, like 14.6, like a charge controller does, it could probably do just as well under certain circumstances, like in bulk mode. But definitely not a replacement for a charge controller. But I think 13.8 is a safe voltage for all 12 volt batteries, and I wouldn't change that. Use cases I've seen people use with this, with or without a battery. You can use it for a chicken coop to run a small fan to keep the chickens cool during the day. If you have a small water feature or water fountain, you can use it to run a small 12 volt pump during the day. Run a small sump pump in a boat, or you can use it for emergency 12 volt battery charging. As always, be careful when using lead acid batteries, especially the ones that aren't sealed. Like, I would never use this indoors or for any serious solar project. But these are great just to use outdoors in an isolated area where they can be safely used. But yeah, I know people use them, but there's just a lot better choices out there, like lithium iron phosphate. All buck converters are not built the same. I had to have this custom built to get it to do what I wanted it to do. Well, I hope this video has gotten you thinking about how you can build small solar systems for small 12 volt projects, and you don't really need to spend a lot of money in order to do it. Thanks for watching.